Let's talk about living things and non-living things. Living things possess characteristics. Non-living things don't possess characteristics. First, let's talk about living things. Living things breathe, like how we breathe in or we breathe out. Living things need food and water. We need food and water to live, or it will be hungry and thirsty. Living things grow, like each body we get taller and older. So, all living things move one to another place. We also move one to another place. Living things feel, when you have a toothache, it pains, right? That's feel, how it feels is a pain. And living things hear, see, smell, and taste. Living things reproduction, like how my mom gave me birth to me. So, living things do this, but non-living things don't do this. I saw this table from here for years, and the table is just the same size. I never saw it giving birth to another one, and I never saw it smell, taste, anything. It didn't do anything. That is what called living things and non-living things. Like living things like plants, humans, and birds and animals. This is one plant. You can see this part. It's called a trendy. It looks for support. When the air comes, it goes around and round and looks for support. That is called a tendril. You can see that tendril? This is called a tendril. This plant was very fun. After some days, after my mom was giving water and food for it, it started growing like a nice flower. See? You can see this part? So, now, see this small flower? It was so small, now it started growing. See, now, we breathe out the carbon dioxide, right? Plants take the carbon dioxide and give us oxygen. Now, do you believe me that plants are living things? Animals also are living things. Living things, and like animals give reproduction, right? So, now living things. Now, do you believe me these are all living things? Like human, animals, birds, and plants. They're all living things. Bye.